Well, it's here. The first laptop to grace our labs, powered by the latest 10th gen Intel Core processors. Dell sponsored this video, unboxing and showcasing the XPS 13 2-in-1, a legitimate contender for daily driver status. So why don't we take it then for a bit of a test drive. All right, let's start by getting this thing cracked open. So first up, we've got our power adapter. Actually, nice and, it's a nice compact one. This isn't much bigger than my old Dell USB to VGA and like hub dongle thing. It's crazy. We've also got a USB-C to USB Type-A dongle. And then that's pretty much it for accessories. Now, let's get to the good stuff. So Dell's been very proud of the steps that they've taken in materials and design over the last handful of years, and the XPS 13 2-in-1 is no exception. It's made of precision milled aluminum for enhanced structural rigidity. I've got the platinum silver color here, and it uses genuine carbon fiber on the palm rest in order to keep down the weight. That was actually one of the biggest issues with early 2-in-1 designs, like my old XPS 12. So it was pretty cool to be able to switch over to tablet mode. But compared to the standalone tablets of the time, they were pretty unwieldy. This is much sleeker. Not everyone cares about touch on laptops, but ever since I went there on my XPS 12, there has been absolutely no going back for me. Now, I/O on this thing is pretty lean, but that's basically a function of how slim the device is. At a starting weight of 2.9 pounds and 7 to 13 millimeters thick, there just isn't room on here for a full-sized HDMI or even USB Type-A port. The good news is that along with the microSD reader and headphone jack, both of those USB Type-C ports can be used to charge the device, and they're Thunderbolt 3 certified, which means you can run high-resolution external displays and get up to 40 gigabit per second of bandwidth for external graphics cards, storage devices, and what have you. All right, let's go ahead and fire up a short stress test. This is Cinebench R20. It's actually kind of amazing to me how little of the chassis is taken up for ventilation. So you've got a handful of vents along the bottom here. And then on older designs, you would often see the entire back end of the keyboard taken up with vents, but that wasn't really possible in a 2-in-1 design like this. So it's just right here under this hinge and this one that it's opened up. Actually, no, there is a small gap there. Oh, interesting. Small though, very small. So Dell is using the 15 watt version of the Core i7 1065 G7 quad core 8-thread processor, which means that you do give up some performance compared to the 25 watt one, but in exchange, you get a surprisingly cool and quiet machine. I've actually been using this for the last week or so, and there we go, we got 980, which is right about what we would expect for a modern performance thin and light. Compared to my usual daily driver, the 16:10 aspect ratio of the display and the keyboard really, really stand out. So Dell has baked a lot of tech into this machine for content consumption. Their branding for it is Cinema Color, Cinema Sound, and Cinema Stream. But here's what all that means, starting with Cinema Color. The display has super narrow infinity edge bezels to improve immersion, including on the top one, where thankfully Dell hasn't removed the HD webcam, unlike some of their competitors. It's available at up to 4K Ultra HD Plus resolution, so that's 3840 by 2400, and I can't emphasize this enough. Man, do those extra vertical pixels make a big difference for productivity. And it's HDR 400 certified and Dolby Vision certified with a peak brightness rating of 500 nits. Just pay careful attention to your HDR settings in Windows, or you might not end up actually experiencing Austin's lovely HDR videos the way that you were intended to. So you actually have to manually say, hey, it's okay for the display to work harder because the brightness is higher while you're running on battery, which I guess makes sense since Full HD HDR content takes the rated battery life from a whopping 17 hours of just using it normally in full HD to 7 hours of streaming. As for Cinema Sound, that's a fancy word for the audio engineering that Dell does on their products, and we've praised them before in the past for the surprisingly wide soundstage and clarity that they pull out of speakers that are firing into the tabletop under the device rather than pointing directly at you. Finally, CinemaStream refers to the built-in Killer Networks Wi-Fi 6 802.11 AX Wi-Fi. So if you don't know all about the benefits of Wi-Fi 6, we actually did a video about that recently, and it is worth a check out when you are done with this one. So initial impressions then, super positive. The display is so bright that in a recent video where we were working on making our own DIY monitor and we set it up next to this one, we actually had to turn this one way down in order to expose properly for both displays. And as I mentioned before, this keyboard was a standout to me right from the word go. So it's got a Windows Hello Ready touch sensor integrated into the power button, and it uses their Gen 2 backlit maglev keyboard switches. These are great. They've got 0.7 millimeters of travel, and more importantly, they've got a really nice sound and tactile feel to them. So far, that's all I've got for impressions of this device, but at the moment, it looks like I'm switching over to it as my daily driver. So after I've had a few more weeks to spend with it, stay tuned for my more detailed review, and make sure that you guys are subscribed so you don't miss it. Thanks again to Dell for sending over the XPS 13 2-in-1 and for sponsoring this video.